Chapter 6. The Hour of Darkness. The Last Supper. Matthew 26:17-46, Mark 14:10-42, Luke 22:7-46, John 13:1-38. As Jesus and his 12 disciples sat around the table to share the Passover meal, Jesus told his friends this would be their last meal together and that a difficult time was coming. Then he took a loaf of bread, blessed it, tore it in pieces, and shared it with everyone at the table. Jesus told them that the bread was like his own body that would be given for them. "Eat this to remember me," he said. Jesus took a cup of wine, blessed it, and shared it with the disciples. "This cup of wine is a reminder of my promise to be your savior," he said. Then Jesus told them something that made them very sad. "One of you will turn against me and will give me to my enemies." "Is it me?" each one asked. "I would never do that," Peter protested. Jesus said, "Peter, I'm sorry to tell you that, before morning, you will deny you know me 3 times before the rooster crows." Later the night Jesus walked to the Mount of Olives where there was a peaceful garden. He knelt down and prayed to his Father in heaven. He asked God to give him the courage to face the troubles ahead. When his prayer time was over, Jesus rejoined the disciples. Suddenly a crowd of angry men showed up, the high priests, temple police, and leaders. One of Jesus' disciples, Judas, was with them. He walked over to Jesus and kissed him. That was a signal to the leaders that Jesus was the one they wanted to arrest. Judas was the traitor. The temple police took Jesus away. The dark night and the dark times had begun. Sneaky schemes and a disloyal disciple. Matthew 26:69-75, Mark 14:66-72, Luke 22:55-62, John 18:16, 25-27. Rattling swords and marching feet broke the quiet in Jerusalem that night. Soldiers and temple leaders hustled Jesus through the dark, sleeping city. Each time the group turned a corner, Peter darted behind a building. "What are these soldiers going to do to Jesus? Where are they taking my Lord? If they see me, will they arrest me too?" Peter wondered. The soldiers pushed Jesus through the gate and into the courtyard of the house where the high priest waited for the prisoner. Peter slipped into the courtyard, close enough to watch and hear what was about to happen. He sat near the fire where others had gathered. He pulled his robe over his head, hoping no one would see his face. A servant girl recognized Peter. "You're with him," she said, pointing to Jesus. "No, no. I don't even know that man," Peter lied. The soldiers began to make fun of Jesus, hitting him and treating him badly. A soldier sitting near Peter said, "Aren't you one of his disciples?" Peter poked the fire with a stick and said, "I don't know what you're talking about." The high priest began asking Jesus questions. Jesus answered, "Everything I've done has been out in the open for all to see. I've taught and ministered, but not in secret. Why are you treating me like this?" Just then a soldier noticed Peter near the fire. "I saw you in the garden with Jesus. You are one of his disciples," he said. Peter denied it. "Not me," he said. Then the courtyard rooster crowed his morning call. The sound of the rooster reminded Peter of Jesus' words. "You will deny me 3 times before the rooster crows." Peter ran out of the courtyard. He cried and cried, disappointed with himself for not being true to Jesus. The Crucifixion. Matthew 27:27-56, Mark 15:16-41, Luke 23:26-49, John 19:17-30. People packed the streets of Jerusalem to look at Jesus. The word was all over town, Jesus had been condemned to die. He had been beaten, spit on, and made fun of. Now the soldiers whipped him, forcing him to march to the place where he would be executed. Crowds of angry citizens who did not believe it was the Son of God wanted him killed, followers of Jesus wanted him saved from the terrible punishment. Men shouted, women cried, children were puzzled by all the commotion. In the middle of all the turmoil, Jesus trudged up the dusty road to the hill called Calvary. Without a word, the weary, beaten Savior struggled under the heavy wooden cross he was forced to carry. The soldiers pounded huge nails through the hands and feet of Jesus and into the cross. They raised the cross, with Jesus on it, and stuck it in the ground. There Jesus hung for hours, in great pain. 2 criminals hung on crosses next to him. Many people made fun of Jesus as he suffered. "If he is the Son of God as he says, let him save himself," they laughed. One of the criminals made fun of him too. But the other criminal believed Jesus was God's Son. "When your kingdom comes, will you save me?" he asked Jesus. And Jesus promised to save him. The painful punishment continued for hours. Jesus' mother and disciples watched, filled with sadness at his suffering. Soon the sun stopped shining. Darkness was all around. Then Jesus cried out, "It is finished!" And he died. Friends of Jesus took his body and buried it in a tomb. It was a sad time for the disciples. They cried for him and prayed together. But Jesus had one more amazing miracle to accomplish.